Octa, where were you?
Me? Oh, just on a little errand. Well, if you want me to be perfectly honest, I was off enjoying myself in the deep forest.
Ah.
I apologize for the delay. However, I reached my fever state a record 592 times.
You counted.
Keeping one's memory sharp is what helps maintain youth, after all. Had you been watching my lady, I likely could have muddied the path an additional 399 times. Lady Three?
Yes?
A good hobby can add spice to anyone's life. However, if they aren't careful, it can also consume their life. Have you ever thought that perhaps you might spend a bit too much time on your doll-making activities?
It's fun. And I have lots of things I want to research.
Of course, my lady. I know how seriously you treat your work, both in the laboratory and between the sheets. And that, you see, is why I can't help but worry. So, what say you set aside your crafts for a spell while we focus on removing a few stubborn clogs from the drain?
No.
My poor loins. I fear they may never be brought to a rolling boil again.
One doesn't understand me. She's like a moon sinking slowly into a sea of blackness.
Did something happen?
One told me to dispatch the children I've been keeping in the land of seeds.
Ah, so that's where your next set of failed experiments are hiding,
Not failed. Gifted. They are gifted children. I don't want to break them.
But if we let them live, my lady, who knows what would happen?
I know. It's just...
My poor lady, I think what you need is a quick game of hide the schnitzel in the moist.
No. Could I even make such masterpieces again? I don't want to go to the land of seeds. I don't want to destroy my children.
I know how you feel, my lady, but we must see this through to the end. It would be most unwise for us to begin questioning Lady One's orders, would it not?
How frustrating.
Now, don't be so gloomy. I shall engrave your wondrous masterpieces forever in my heart.
Really? What color are the fireworks of hope?
Why the strange riddles, my lady?
Make sure you really do look closely and engrave them in your heart. Never forget it. That's our iridescent promise.
Oh, a coliseum, I see. Is this where you left your masterpieces, Lady Three?
Yes. My masterpieces. The greatest work of my life.
this is your greatest work? These gigantes? I suppose they do have something of an elegant air.
No.
Oh?
These are normal children. A warlock.
I beg your pardon, my lady. These old eyes have seen better days. Of course, my third eye still sharp as a tack. These gigantes seem a bit rotten. Did you make them as well?
No. Think of these children as merely spare parts. They're the junk left over from my other work, like the bones of a half-eaten fish.
I must say, I'm starting to feel a bit bad for them. Something seems a tad different with these gigantes.
Yes. That's because I crossed them with humans.
Humans? But, my lady, that...
See, look at how they talk. A regular Gigas is totally incapable of speaking. But crossing them with humans was hard because human minds and bodies are such fragile frames. Once you scare a human, it's no longer useful. Just the sight of that makes them freeze up. So I had to mix and match a bit to try and get the results I was looking for. First, I had to figure out a way to stop the screaming, which took a little while. Then I had to clear up all the goo and junk, which took even longer. I had to work fast, you see, because time was pretty short.
No, dear.
But it didn't work. A simple melding of human and Gigas, I mean. Humans are far less durable than gigantes, for one. That makes it hard to balance them out. I tried. I killed lots and lots of humans and gigantes along the way. It was the only way. I had so many beloved soldiers I wanted to build.
Lady Three. Travels in a straight line. I recommend taking refuge in the alley at once. Your back, my lady, lest you subject yourself to a pincer attack.
But my research found the answer. Human strength is governed by emotion.
Your research?
Yes, my research. Research to create the perfect soldier. I decided I had to cross between assorted emotion sets.
Cross? You don't mean...
Of course I do. Why wait for the right emotions to come along and it's quicker to make them yourself?
How many people died for this, my lady?
56.
You counted?
Keeping one's memory sharp is what helps maintain youth, after all.
I cannot believe this.
Octa, hey Octa, guess what? Come on, Octa, ask me.
I cannot, my lady.
You want to know which humans have the highest durability levels? The ones who are filled with hate? So I gathered up a few nearby villagers and I...
Please, my lady, no more.
I killed a guy right in front of them. They didn't even see it coming. Just hacked him into little bits.
My... lady.
And then while everyone was standing around, all shocked and horrified, I made him into a soldier. Right there on the spot. It was a total success. Isn't that great? You know, Octa, thinking of the right situation to amplify human hatred is so much fun. Humans get angry at the littlest things. You'd be surprised how easy it was to set them off. Like I threatened to kill the women before killing the men. That made the men so angry. They couldn't even stand it. Then I'd tell everyone I was gonna make them watch. I'd threaten to hold their eyes open with my own two hands. And then I'd grab my scissors and flash until the started flying. It was great. Oh, and blood sprays really boost the hate. Isn't this all just the best?
Stop, my lady, please! I cannot take any more!
Soldiers make you hate or strong. They fight like no one else. Although they are just a little hard to control. Maybe that's why one never wanted to accept them. She never accepted these children, just like she never accepted me for giving them life. Why? Why, Octa? Isn't that cruel of her? Don't you think? How could she dismiss such beautiful, gifted children? They're the best soldiers ever.
Forgive me, my lady. But I, too, simply cannot accept it.
Huh? What? I can't hear you. People grow stronger when they lose something precious. So I take whatever is most precious to them. I take it and create powerful soldiers. Octa.
Yes, my lady.
What is most precious to you? The Intoner's hobby caused her to lay hands upon human beings. Once she crossed that line, nothing could stop her. The elderly man silently excused himself from the room. He chided himself for his impotence, as he mourned for his now broken intoner.
Thank you.